Turning now to cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin prices stabilized just below $50,000 following a wild weekend of trading. It last traded at $49,122 Sunday afternoon after dropping more than 17% to as low as $43,000 on Saturday. Bitcoin's sharp tumble follows Friday's risk-off tone in broader markets as the Omicron variant spread further. It also builds on recent declines for the digital coin, which officially entered bear market territory last month after dropping to a then seven-week low of $54,000. Bitcoin is now nearly 30% below its all-time high of $69,000, which it hit in early November. China's securities regulator says it respects the decision of some Chinese companies to delist from the New York Stock Exchange, but it says reports that Chinese regulators are urging or pressuring firms to drop their U.S. listings are completely misleading. It adds local companies are actively working with Chinese regulators to have shares listed abroad. China's statement comes after ride-hailing giant Didi Chuxing said it's planning to delist from the New York Stock Exchange just 5 months after its debut in July. Didi has been under fire in China as Beijing implements a sweeping regulatory crackdown on tech companies. But authorities there assert recent policy moves are not aimed at specific industries or companies. Good news for motorists, a big-time local oil price rollback is had to happen this week. Gasoline prices may go down by up to 2 pesos and 70 centavos per liter. Diesel and kerosene prices may see slightly bigger price cuts of 2 pesos and 80 centavos per liter. Industry players say the drop in local pump prices is due to declining demand in the world oil market as more countries reimpose travel bans due to the Omicron variant. Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi and UDENA Chairman Dennis Uy opened to withdrawing the libel suit they filed against nearly two dozen media practitioners if they publicly apologize to them. That's according to Cusi and Uy's lawyer, attorney Ruy Alberto Rondon. The two have accused 17 journalists of reporting false and libelous statements on their involvement in the controversial Malampaya deal. Cusi and Uy are facing a graft complaint before the ombudsman over UDENA's acquisition of a 90% stake in Malampaya. But Rondon claims the journalists involved merely based their stories on a press conference held by the complainants as an actual complaint had yet to be filed at that time.
If you see something that's filed and docketed, it's stamped, received, then you can rely on that. That becomes an official proceeding and you can report on it without fear of a libel. They say that there was a complaint, but no one has seen, I haven't seen the complaint and no one has shown me a complaint. They said terrible things about this being the biggest crony case in history, biggest crony gift in history, about a massive graft. Imagine how their children feel. Imagine how they feel. So they have to vindicate their honor by filing the libel cases. But I'm sure my clients are open to it, a sincere apology, a genuine apology.